there, welcome to my show here on Rogers 4. It's all about me and what I do and everything else, you know, about me.
So, excuse me, Ryan. First off, it's our show.
Yeah.
And it's called Pork Chop Soup.
This is Leah. This is right there.
And I'm Ryan.
And, well, I'm Rob.
I'm Kim.
I'm Sean. And there's a lot more people that are involved in this. Like Daryl, who's working on the camera
right now.
And as you saw, there is a few more people, as you saw in our little fancy opening there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh. So, basically, this is our couch. How do you like our couch?
Say hi to the
It's time for commercial. So,
commercial.
Go to commercial.
Here's Tiny Toner.
Let's get motivated! Phony Little back here again for an all-new body workout extravaganza. In the past, I've worked out your hips, your thighs, your knees, your feet, everything. But now, we have something that'll work out your whole entire body! It's called Tiny Toner! Give it to me! This little puppy right here will work out everything you have in your body. Oh, yeah. Okay, let's bring out Bouncy Brenda here to show how it works. Okay, Brenda, take this puppy. Let's show them how it's done. Oh, yeah, technique, technique. Other side, baby, flip around. Oh, yeah, look at this. Look at the calories she's burning. Ouch, get on the floor, baby. Oh, God. Now look at this. Is this not technique? Technique, technique, technique. That's all it needs. Now get up, baby. Okay, right on the spot. Look at her go. Look at this. Look how that little piece of plastic, the Tiny Toner, is working out everything. Thanks, Brenda. Okay, anyway, like I said, this will give you a full body workout for just $39.99. Three easy payments. That's it. I'll see you later.
I've tried everything to get into better shape. I spent thousands of dollars. Maybe I'll call Phony's hotline.
Hello, operator. Tell me about that Tiny Toner.
Well, caller, I'd be happy to.
How long will it take to get here, operator?
It's on its way right now.
That was so fast, operator.
And now for my next number, I'd like to return to the classics. La, la, la.
Def Jam.
Here it is.
Okay.
Cut it.
Hi, I'm Kristen, and we're in the Coffee Jam kitchen, and I'm here with my friend Jeff, and I'm just going to ask him a couple questions about Coffee Jam. So, how did this all start?
Well, I guess a few months ago, some youth and Kevin and Diana from Parks and Rec and City Hall decided that they wanted to give kids something to do on a Friday night. So they kind of got it together and decided to get some bands to play. Kind of took it from there, got some refreshments, and kept ticket prices low. So that's pretty much what they did.
So who's this run by besides Kevin and Diana?
Well, it's basically run by the Coffee Jam Committee, which is about 12 or 15 youth. And they have meetings usually every 1 or 2 weeks. And they come up with ideas for the next Coffee Jam to make each one better, I guess.
Cool. How often are these Coffee Jams on?
They're usually on once a month, on depending on the scheduling, usually the third Friday of each month.
And what do you, as students, do?
Well, me myself, I'm involved in some of the booking of the bands and the organizational and setup part of it. But there's lots of jobs to be done, like organizing the refreshments and I guess getting all the bands together and doing the setup, stuff like that.
Have you had a fairly big response as for teens coming here?
Yeah, usually the limit is 300 people and we usually come pretty close to filling that up, so it's pretty good.
And I understand that you kind of sponsor this as a drug and alcohol-free concert. Do you think that that really has any effect on what happens out there?
Yeah, I think it's pretty good because they usually check people coming in, you know, for like drugs or alcohol or whatever. And they try and keep it pretty clean. So, I don't know, most people come in and try and enjoy it for the bands. You know.
And how much do you sell tickets for?
Tickets are $2 in advance or $3 at the door. You get them for $2 in advance, usually from people at your school or else from the city hall or from the civic center. And they're $3 at the door.
Hi, I'm Tyler for Pork Chop Soup, and we're here with Diana Fast. And Diana, what is it exactly that you do with Parks and Rec?
Well, first of all, Tyler?
Yeah.
Is that right? Okay. First of all, I work for the City of Langley Parks and Recreation Department, and I do lots for them. My title is called a program supervisor, so that's what I do. I supervise programs, and I develop programs, and I organize them, and I run them. And one really successful one that we've been doing is, as you know, the Coffee Jam.
Right, so it's a community thing, and
yeah, totally.
They happen when? Every 2 weeks, is it?
We have it once a month.
Once a month?
Yeah, and we've been doing them since September 94.
All right, so the next one is?
March 95. I think it's March 17th.
All right, so anybody that wants to come, there's posters around the school?
Yeah, there's posters around the school. You can buy your tickets at the Langley Civic Center or the Langley City Hall downtown by the library. Or you can buy them from students in the schools. We've got about 15 kids on our committee, and they sell tickets as well before the event. So it's really easy to get a ticket.
Right, and it's all volunteers.
Yeah, We also have a bunch of students from Trinity supplying their time. They're all volunteering to help us kind of keep an eye on things, keep things running smoothly in during the evenings. And it's great because the students from Trinity are more the youth age, you know, so it's not like we've got some old geezers in here that are, you know, 40, 50 years old, because usually kids don't really relate well with them, but they can relate well with the students because they're so close in age, so it works a lot better.
Great. Well, thanks a lot, Diana, and we hope to see turnouts at the rest of the Coffee Jam and hope it's a very big success.
Well, thanks, Tyler. Thanks. And may I add one more thing?
Yeah, go ahead.
We are planning on doing a kind of mini Lollapalooza this summer. It's in the works, and what we're planning on doing is getting bands that have played for us during the whole year to come and play at this mini Lollapalooza. We hope to get about, you know, 1,000 to 2,000 kids out on a day. Like, we want to have it during the day outside, say in a park or something like that. So people can look forward to that because we're hoping really to get that going.
Thanks for your time, Diana. For Pork Chop Soup, I'm Tyler.
Hi there, and now it's time for the serious part of Pork Chop Soup, where we have our documentary, our news line on PCS.
It's about Earthquake High. Good evening. Welcome to Newsline on PCS. I'm Zorinka Rukavina at Earthquake High. This school was built in Sun Valley, California 25 years ago on a fault line due to a lack of funds. Now, for 3 minutes out of each hour, the kids do their homework when there's peace, and 57 minutes of every hour, there are earthquakes. Is the school safe? That's what we're gonna find out tonight. Here we are at a boys' basketball practice at Earthquake High, where one devoted superstar continues to play despite all the earthquakes. Now, is this school safe?
Of course.
And, oh, looks like one earthquake is just about to hit. I'm out of here.
Oh!
Kimber. Here she is with Bird's Eye View.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to my segment. On this part of the show, I'll be featuring local bands from the Langley, Surrey, and New West areas. For my first band in our first show, I had to go searching around through the bands that I know and have seen. And so our show's not biased towards our friends' bands, it's up to you to send in tapes, audio or video, of your bands so we can contact you so you can be on our show. Now as my first band, I have a trio from White Rock, who've been together for 2 years and have played at Vancouver clubs such as the Town Pump and the Starfish Room. They have also played at Whistler and various clubs in Northwest United States. They've released 4 independent cassettes, their latest being Tightly Fixed. Here's Paisley Suitcase.
Thank you.
sitting here with Paisley suitcase. And you are?
I'm Kevin.
I'm Mark.
John.
We got our name 4 years ago when we started this band. And it was actually a couple months later, but after we started, because we were going through a process of trying to pick a band name. But John and a good friend of ours, Josh, were in math class, and they wrote one page, I believe, of band names down. And Paisley's Suitcase turned out to be the best one on the page, so it just kind of stuck. Has no great significance.
That's a good story. I've never heard it before.
Describe your recording process with your last tape there.
Well, basically what happened was we went to the studio in Richmond with our producer, Michelle Garouk. She's worked with many groups such as Omni. Oh, I can't lie. She never worked with Katie Lang, I don't think. Went in for 2 days, we recorded everything live off the floor, except for vocals. We recorded for 1 day, and then we mixed for a day. Don and I put the artwork together on his computer, and I'm really happy with it.
And what are your plans for your upcoming CD?
Well, some of those plans are still in the works. We plan to work, hopefully go in for more than 2 days, and to do at least 10 or 12 songs, or maybe even like 20. I really think it's cool when a band does like big CDs. I think that's cool, because we've never done a full-length album, so. So, yeah, it's going to be really good.
And you plan for it to come out?
Mostly in Vancouver, in Canada, North America.
Well, soon, or?
Hopefully we'll produce it independently and then get a distribution deal with someone to distribute across North America. Soon is a tough word.
Now, I described your band as a trio. How long has it been a trio for?
Well, we've been a trio since April, and before that we had a pianist for the last year, and his name is Nate, and he's a really good guy, but he decided to move on to other things, so we're just a trio now. And before that, we had another guy named Ryan who played guitar, and he decided to move on to bigger, greater things, too. So.
Our song styles change around a lot and stuff, and we like a lot of music, and I think that comes out in our songs. I hope that we have some kind of cohesive sound that is Paisley's Suitcase, but we do like lots of different styles, and it seems like our songs change around a lot. And someone just said to us, they like coming to our concerts because every time they come, we sound like someone different. Oh, not like someone, we just sound different. Yeah.
To go along with that, with the last little while, we've actually changed stylistically dramatically in that, because with Nate going, because he played piano and he wrote half the songs and he also sang lead. Some people called him our front man because sometimes he wouldn't be playing anything, he'd be singing, just singing. And so, you know, a lot of, like, between our third tape, That Ain't the Way It Was Meant to Be, and Tightly Fixed now as a trio, our trio tape, there's a significant difference, but I mean, it's still quite obvious it's the same band, but, you know, people will figure that out for themselves. But.
Sacred anymore.
What do I need? Let's see here. Ah, yes. Gripsum denture cream. Yes!
Gripsum denture cream. A little dab will do ya.
Okay! Now, here's our next segment on the show. It's a little interview with Rebels Without Applause. I hope you enjoy it. Whoops, you fell there, bud.
Hurry up, John Paul, and finish your breakfast. We're gonna be late for church.
Okay, Mommy. There's nothing good to eat on Sunday mornings. I wish that I could have something that's not only delicious and nutritious, but that spreads the faith of the Old Testament all in one bowl. What's this new cereal Mom bought? I guess I'll give it a whirl. Holy Moses!
Crunch.
Hi there, kids. I'm Munchy Moses, and these are the Angels of Almonds. And yes, this is Holy Moses Crunch. It's the only cereal where the milk actually parts. In each box, you'll be blessed with crispy Jesus flakes, oat bread Marys, marshmallow messiahs, and yes, 12 corn pop disciples. And for a limited time, you get Nutty Noahs, the nuts that float through the milk. Two by two. This is surely a breakfast fit for the King of Kings. And remember, kids,
two scoops of rum in every box of Holy Moses.
Crunch.
With seven heavenly nutrients.
Amen.
Hi, I'm Zrinka and Leah, and this is an interview with Rebels Without Applause. Well, three of them anyway. Hi.
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 And you are?
I'm Brent.
I am Todd.
And I'm Kim.
Kim?
No, Ken.
We like to call him Kim, but you know that's just the closest friends. Most people just call him Ken.
It's an inside thing.
Yeah, real inside.
Oh really?
When did you guys get together?
Mm-hmm. 2 years. Since about grade 11, we were sort of bumming around in high school, and one day we decided we'd actually do some work, and we did.
Yep.
Now we're bumming around professionally.
Do you have some kind of writing process that you use?
It's something we call a creative exuberance. I don't know where that term originated,
I remember.
Sounds good, don't it?
Yeah. It's basically just we get together, laugh a little, cry a little, and come up with a sketch or two. And
how it's done.
That goes on to a show, and then we rehearse, and da-da-da-da-da, and we put up a show, and that's that.
So the new show, what's it called?
We got a working title. We don't know if we're going to use it yet, but it's Putting on the Skits.
And is there a basic plot?
There's no basic plot. It's we've done the other two shows we did. There's no basic plot. It's skit humor. It's based on youth experiences. You know, we deal with everything from religion to breakfast cereal to drugs to
pasta,
all kinds of stuff. It's how we view. I don't know if it's how we view the world, but we feel it's a view from a younger generation, kind of satirizing what they see.
What's going on today?
We do a lot of commercial humor. I mean, there's a lot of commercialism in the world right now, and we kind of look at that.
Speaking of world issues, what do you think about euthanasia?
Yeah.
I'm really glad you asked that, actually. This is an issue that's been bothering me for a while. I hear a lot of people saying we don't believe in euthanasia, which, I mean, quite frankly, it's a moronic statement. How can you not believe in euthanasia? I mean, I know Chinese kids. I've seen photos of them in China. I've seen Sally Struthers talking to these kids. There are youth in Asia.
It's really incredible, the ignorance. I mean, what do you mean, do we believe in euthanasia? I mean, of course. I mean, it's the population. It's like, okay, they say, the thing that gets me about the euthanasia,
that's just it. We've seen them.
Yeah.
You can't deny it.
There's no covering it up.
They're there. I mean, think of this. The government in China is, okay, this is what they're doing, right? They're granting families who have less kids more money. And what's with that, okay? I mean, yeah, I guess I can see that happening, but, you know, who wants the government to control your family? I mean, it's...
That proves there's euthanasia.
I mean, it's just not a lie. If there were no euthanasia, then where would China's future be today?
If you don't believe in euthanasia, you're just racist. That's it.
It's prejudice, man.
You're a bigot.
Prejudice.
You're a bigot.
You're stereotypical racists and fascism.
Okay, well, what about gun control? Do you have any way to fix the problems with guns?
Mm-hmm. Well, the thing about gun control is, it's, you know, I hear it's a disputed issue right now, and that bothers me again because the facts are the facts. Guns are controlled. They don't just go off by themselves. People are behind the trigger. I mean, guns are controlled.
I mean, there is a certain amount of thinking behind the gun. I mean, the gun doesn't think for itself. I mean, that'd be kind of crazy. Gun control, I mean, it shouldn't be. I mean, if you want to control a gun, then it's not so much controlling the gun, but controlling the bullets. I mean, it's...
Yeah, the bullets do, like, I know guns are dangerous, but the bullets seem to do a little more damage.
Yeah, they tend to, like...
I've seen people hit with a gun, and it's messy.
It hurts a little bit.
It's messy, but I mean, the bullets...
Some bullets.
Yeah, the bullets tend to do more.
Yeah, you should really limit bullets, or cut them out completely. Just cut them out completely. I mean,
that would solve a lot of problems.
Keep guns, wipe
no
out
bullets.
Yeah.
So, do you have any clips or anything we could show our viewers of the previous shows?
That's odd. We actually do have a clip.
That's great. Here's a clip of Rebels Without Applause in action.
Please, don't do it. Think about the future. Think about your family, man.
I can't help it.
It just overwhelms me. I become a slave to the rhythm. I can't stop, I'm sorry.
Please, stop while you still have time. I don't want to lose you. You mean too much to me, man.
I'm sorry, you just don't understand. I mean, when I hear that Latin beat, my buttocks start shaking, and my pelvis starts quaking. And pretty soon, I have to lambada!
No! That's the forbidden dance!
Freeze, Baryshnikov!
There'll be no lambada on my beat.
I can't stop.
Well, I guess there's only one thing we can do.
Not that.
I'm afraid so, Cochise.
You mean the soapy frogs and squeegee routine?
Nah, that's rookie stuff. We're bringing in the big guns.
No, not.
Chariots of Fire.
Show. As you see, it's just a bunch of us getting together, having some fun, sharing ideas. But what we want from you people out there, our viewing audience, is your ideas, not our ideas, your ideas. We need your tapes, your scripts, anything you got, socks, underwear, we don't care. Just please send us those right away. The address is at the bottom of the screen, so please write it down. Tell your relatives, your family members, anyone you know, your dog, your bird, your cat, I don't care. Just hurry and send them for our next show. Thanks for watching. The next step.